we'll hear from Senator Jean Shaheen from New Hampshire. As governor of New Hampshire, Senator Shaheen enacted the New Hampshire's Children's Health Insurance Program, which provides affordable health and dental coverage to tens of thousands of children in her state. She also initiated a senior prescription drug program, providing seniors with lower cost prescription drugs. I yield 4 minutes to the senator from New Hampshire.
Thank you, Senator Merkley. Madam President.
Senator from New Hampshire.
I want to begin by thanking Senator Merkley for coordinating this effort today. I'm pleased to be able to once again join my fellow freshman senators in discussing how critical it is for the Senate to act on health care reform. As the Senate moves to reform our broken health care system, we must address the skyrocketing costs of health care, and we must ensure quality in our health care system. Over the past several months, I've heard from many individuals and families from New Hampshire who are dealing with rising health care costs. The stories they tell me are the most poignant reminders of why we must reform our health care system. Recently, I heard from a man named Jeff, who is from Loudoun, a small community close to the capital city of Concord. Jeff had recently lost his job and with it his health insurance. So when he experienced swelling of his right leg and shortness of breath, he was afraid to go to the doctor because he was afraid he couldn't afford the cost. So he ignored the symptoms until he got so bad that he had to call 911 and he was taken to a local hospital. Doctors realized that he had a blood clot in his leg which had migrated to his lungs. This was a life-threatening condition called a pulmonary embolism. Since treatment, his condition has improved dramatically. However, the final bill from the hospital was over $200,000, and so to this day, Jeff remains in debt. Just think how much we could have saved if he could have gone to the doctor when he first felt those symptoms. Mr. President, stories like this are unacceptable, and they can happen to anyone. The truth is, like Jeff, we may be all one medical condition away from financial disaster because of the high costs of health care. So we must work to protect hardworking individuals and families as we put forward a bill. Now, I'm proud to come from New Hampshire for so many reasons, but one of them is because of the great work that's done by the Dartmouth Institute of Health Policy. For more than 20 years, Dartmouth has been a leader in comparative effectiveness research and has revolutionized our understanding of our healthcare system. Because of the Dartmouth Atlas Project, we now know that there are huge variations in the way healthcare resources are used and how money is spent depending on where we live. Now, this chart shows the difference in spending among different regions per Medicare patient. And it's amazing to me that Medicare costs can range from the lowest spending referral region, which as you can see here is just over $5,000, to the highest spending referral region, where in some parts of the country, Medicare pays over $14,000 to provide the same kind of treatment that in other parts of the country is provided by only a little over $5,000. Unfortunately, the research also shows that just because someone lives in a higher spending area, it doesn't mean that they're going to live longer or have better health outcomes. So, simply put, more costly care does not mean better care. This is a fundamental problem with our health care system and something we've got to work on. Things don't have to be this way. We can find savings in our system and still provide high quality care. As I mentioned last week, we can save significantly on Medicare costs by reducing hospital readmissions. And I've introduced bipartisan legislation with Senator Collins to do just that. We have the opportunity to fix a problem that's been around for generations. We need to work together to achieve this goal. Thank you, Mr. President. I yield the floor.